Why, hello, and welcome to another episode of Alotru Guide. I'm your host and guide, Zaldar Shield, and today I want to do a quick little video on why is Lotru one of the best MMOs ever? All right, so that's the title of this video today, is why is Lotru one of the best MMOs of all time from my experiences, all right? And for you guys, if you would like to get into the game, okay? Again, I don't want this to be clickbaity, so I'm just gonna tell you my experiences and why I think it's a great game, and I've played a lot of other MMOs as well. There are lots of other great disclaimer MMOs out there as well, so this is not an attack on any of them, so please, if you're someone who plays another MMO, do not feel like you're being attacked. All right, so first of all, it's Lord of the Rings, you guys. Tolkien. Everyone loves Tolkien. He's been around for 100 years, the Tolkien stuff, pretty much, almost. And we all love it. All over the world, we love Tolkien's works, okay? That is one thing, all right? So now let's go into the MMO. So they have a great baseline, right? They have the world of Middle-earth and Tolkien's lore. So that's baseline number one, right? All right, the next thing, let's talk about the actual gameplay. I actually greatly like it. It's a very classic style MMO gameplay, and I really like the way it plays, right? Now granted, it's my age, it's my time, it's not for everyone, but I would recommend it for everyone to at least try it for a couple hours, because it is a great game. Now, another huge thing besides gameplay is the music. The music you're hearing right now by Chance Thomas. Now, I've gotten the privilege of interviewing Chance Thomas in person before, and hopefully we'll have him on the channel in the future. He's already agreed to come on, which is exciting. But the music is gorgeous. It is beautiful. It just encapsulates everything we love about Middle-earth, okay? So the music is great. It's right up there with the level of the movies from Howard Shore's music. So Chance Thomas did a fantastic job, and a couple other composers who did music for it, but he was one of the main ones. And music's amazing, okay? So that's a huge one. That's another huge one. Another big one is storytelling, okay? So the storytelling in the Lord of the Rings Online is so well done with the lore. Now granted, one thing that I've always wanted to be able to, here's a little plug-in for my channel if you guys want to subscribe and like, if you have earned it, of course, is that one of the things is they don't always do a ton of voiceovers, but that's like every MMO, really. They don't always send us to a little clip at the beginning, and then you have to read the paragraph about the story of the quest you're doing. I do a lot of voiceovers for those characters, all right? So that's hence Voice of the Rings. But the stories are so well written, so well thought out. They have literal lore masters that do the lore for this game that make sure they stay true to Tolkien when they make up names for NPCs and stuff. Amazing work, amazingly done, you guys. This is another huge thing. The stories, so music, story, gameplay, the visuals. I know a lot of people, some people will be like, oh, I don't know about the visuals, right? And again, go watch any of my Lotru Tour episodes, my newer videos. I have a new system now. It really does matter how good your system is for this game, surprisingly, even though it is an older game. But it looks gorgeous for its age, okay? The game still looks amazing. It really has held up the test of time. So, and they've been updating stuff right now. Another big thing is really the people who have run this game. They really love Tolkien and they really love their community. They haven't always had all the funding in the world, but right now they have really good funding because it's really growing right now, the game again. It's up and downs in its lifetime. But it is on a high point again, and we are not going anywhere. So that's another huge one. So if you're willing to try it, don't feel that it's gonna go away immediately. It's not. We have many years to go of this game. Just like many other MMOs, but you know, some have crashed in the past, some have not. But again, another reason, it's stayed strong, steady, and true this whole time. Another huge thing why I think it's one of the best MMOs out there, because they really care about their community. That's a big one. They've extremely cared about their community. They love their players. The overall majority of the community has always been like, they listen to us when we complain about something or when we thank them about something. So that's another big one. That's really huge. You really have to have people, creators, that love their community and their stories that they're making. Otherwise, you just don't have a good game. Hence why Lord of the Rings Online, another reason why I think it's one of the best MMOs ever made. It is, at the time of its placement in right now and when it first came out, it was at a very good spot, right? Because it came out at a time that people had known about the Lord of the Rings well, and then in the middle of this game's life, the Hobbit movies came out, right? And now at another huge point in its life, which is probably still in the middle of its life. I mean, I wouldn't know that right now at the time of this video. But you know, we're having more series come out. We're having the Rohirrim series by New Line Cinema. We're having the Amazon Rings of Power series, right? These are all bolstering the game. Another reason to come and play the game, you guys. They're working greatly on the graphical engine of this game. They are updating things right now, still. This game has been upgraded all the time. Now, granted, there is a level of where they're not going to be able to completely get to. You're not going to be able to get to a new graphical system entirely, but the game still looks great. And if you have a really good computer, it does matter. You can play this game. Here's another good thing. You can play it on a scrapper computer and a computer that's the best there are, and both will be a positive. As in, if you're playing on a scrapper, you just want to play the game, you'll be able to play the game. But if you're playing on a really good computer, like my system, you're going to see really good quality and really good graphics and enjoy the experience. So both ways, you'll enjoy the experience, but it's really fun to be able to see really good visuals, which the game, that's another big one, okay, guys? The visuals of the game, the scenery, the feeling, the immersion of the storytelling with the music, with the visuals, with the gameplay, what you're doing, what you're trying to do, amazing. Again, if I hop back to the story, you go along with the Fellowship and they just make you feel like the character you made, it's really possible, right? That you really are in the story with them. That's a big one, right? So you like, when you pop back in your mind and you think about a thing in the Lord of the Rings books, you're like, oh yeah, and my character did that in the background to help them. And then you go, oh wait, no, that actually wasn't written in the books. But then you think it comes back to you like that. The nostalgia of this game, that's how well it's written, the stories, okay? So huge, fantastic. So again, I did not want this to be a clickbait video. I just wanted a real quick video for you guys to just give you a couple things, just to let you know, as someone who loves this game greatly, but also, since I've played it a long time, I can judge it as well as tell the positives, but overall the pros outweigh the cons, my friends, and right now is a great time to play the game, so definitely play it. And if you are someone who likes the Lord of the Rings Online or any Lord of the Rings content, right, again, I'm someone who my channel focuses on all Lord of the Rings things, even though Lotro is my canvas, I do most content in this video game, but I do all sorts of Lord of the Rings stuff. So if you like Lord of the Rings stuff, don't forget to subscribe. It's free, my friends. And you guys have a wonderful day in Middle Earth. Thank you for watching all the video if you did. Thank you to my wonderful patrons for your support. It means a lot. Next episode for guides are up there. I do lots of guides on this game if you need it, if you're new. Great time to start, you guys. And my main content is over there where I do voiceovers in this game. And I will see you all in the next episode of Voice of the Rings. I'm your host and guide, Zolan Ironshield, as always, like I said. And you guys have a great day in Middle Earth, and I hope to see you in the Lord of the Rings Online. See ya.